Humanity has long survived the wrath of Mother Nature, from hurricanes to earthquakes and tsunamis. However, she has a lot more to offer us than catastrophic events. We need to ask ourselves where we would be without fresh water. The answer is simple. We would not exist. The importance of fresh water to human life must be carefully dealt with, as nearly 70% is locked up in solid form as glaciers. The remainder of fresh water is found trapped underground and non-accessible, and less than 1% is found in rivers, streams, and more abundantly, lakes. If we want to continue our success on this earth, we must continually monitor and take care of our freshwater sources. This is possible through the study of inland waters, called limnology.
The Great Lakes, which border Canada and the United States, hold approximately 20% of the world's available freshwater. Interestingly enough, there is one very special lake located in southern Siberia which contains the same amount. We will now travel across the globe to the Pearl of Siberia, Lake Baikal.
Besides containing 20% of the Earth's fresh water, this lake is also the oldest, largest by volume, and most biotically diverse lake in the world. 25 million years ago, two tectonic plates spread apart. The resulting basin that formed filled full of water from surrounding rivers and streams, forming a rift lake that is now Lake Baikal. The plates are still diverging at a rate of 4 millimeters per year. Baikal has a maximum depth of 1.6 kilometers and a surface area of 31,500 square kilometers. Contributing to its massive volume are 365 rivers flowing into the lake, which result in an estimated hydraulic residence time of 330 years.
Of the 365 rivers, there are five main tributaries to the lake. They are the Barguzin, Upper Anjara, Turka, Chesnaya, and Selanga. The Selanga River is the largest tributary to Lake Baikal, contributing 50% of the lake's surface water. Although the lake is connected with so many inlets, there is only one outlet for the water to exit. It is called the Anjara River.
Research in paleoclimatology of Baikal has proven there has been a dramatic shift in air temperature in the past century, an increase of approximately 1.2 degrees. Lake Baikal's surface waters also have increased down to a depth of 25 meters over the past 60 years. If these trends continue, there will be repercussions involving ice cover, mixing activity, nutrient loading, and resulting effects to the life forms within the lake. The lake is home to over 2,500 species, and over half of them are endemic, meaning they are only found in Lake Baikal. These species include certain types of zooplankton and amphipods, to larger animals like the Baikal oilfish, and the world's only exclusively freshwater seal. The life cycle and food webs of these animals begin with the production of the primary producers, such as phytoplankton.
Unlike many lakes, the diatoms found at Lake Baikal require ice cover for habitat and reproduction. Like almost all primary producers, they require sunlight to carry on photosynthesis for food. The ice on many parts of the lake is very transparent and absent of snow due to strong winds. Therefore, the sun can get through to the water beneath and become available to the diatoms. They stay suspended in the photic zone as a result of effective mixing that continually pushes them to the surface. This convective mixing is also a result of the sun's energy, related to differences in water density.
With increases in temperature, we will see a decrease in the amount of time that ice covers the lake. In fact, Studies have revealed that from year 1869 to 2000, the temporal lake of ice cover has shortened by 18 days. During the months just before ice breakup, phytoplankton rapidly reproduce in what is called the spring bloom. If there is no ice cover during this time, there will be no spring bloom, resulting in very little phytoplankton production. Before these changes occur, it is likely the ice will change in transparency with changes in temperature. It will become less transparent, resulting in less light or food reaching the surface water. As the main primary producer in the lake, with these changes, a gap may form in the food chain, ultimately affecting many species.
With the loss of ice, there will be no surface on the lake for snow to settle. This would be detrimental to the success of the Baikal seal. In order for the seals to reproduce and raise their young, they require ice and snow to make dens. The dens protect the pups from predators as they grow into mature individuals. The Baikal seal is at the top of the aquatic food chain in the lake, and if we see a decline or loss of population, other species further down the chain will rapidly rise in numbers. This would drastically alter the ecology of the lake, and the seal could face extinction.
As we dive deep into the lake, a new world is displayed, consisting of many endemic species. Freshwater sponges cling to the rocks, mollusks scour the lake bed in search of food, but most interestingly, we start to see species that are usually fairly small as giants. This is mostly due to the presence of dissolved oxygen at the lake's deepest depths.
Because of the lake's enormous depth, stratification only occurs in the upper 250 to 300 meters. It undergoes fall and spring overturn, and when stratified, thermocline is present for roughly 7 weeks. If mixing only occurs in the upper levels of the lake, then how is oxygen getting to the bottom? During the spring thaw and just before ice cover, the upper 300 meters of water is more dense than the water underneath. Due to the effects that pressure has on density, the water from the top sinks to the bottom, bringing along the dissolved oxygen with it.
In the near future, this mixing may not occur if surface water temperatures rise and decrease in density. All species living near or on the bed of the lake will either have to adapt to an environment with less oxygen, or they will perish. Along with decreasing ice cover, this too would be catastrophic to the unique ecology of Lake Baikal. The topics that have been covered are only a few factors that will have an influence on the lake's future. Others, like anthropogenic stresses such as pulp and paper mills on the Selenga River, agricultural practices sending excess nutrient loads into the lake, and proposed developments surrounding this natural beauty will also alter Lake Baikal.
Freshwater sustainability is not only vital for human life, but also for the vast amount of species living within or near bodies of water. Monitoring and maintaining these sources will not only help to prevent degradation of water quantity and quality, but will also aid in sustaining the vast network of ecosystems within. Because of Lake Baikal's water purity and endemic biodiversity, it will be a shame to see a species disappear.
If the lake is the pearl, then Siberia is the oyster. And we hope the oyster will continue to protect its pearl, that is, Lake Baikal.
Trust it. It's evolution, baby.